Israeli riot police rush forward, firing rubber-coated steel bullets, trying to disperse hundreds of Palestinian protesters in El Bire on the West Bank. This was the day of rage Palestinian leaders called for to protest Israeli policies on the Temple Mount, or the Haram al-Sharif, as it's known to Muslims, site of the Aqsa Mosque. As long as we don't have Al-Aqsa and don't have a country, vows protester Noor, we'll stay here and fight this intifada. Israeli forces fired volley after volley of tear gas, while trucks sprayed copious quantities of what's known as skunk water, putrid-smelling, chemically-treated liquid intended to disperse crowds. The crowd dispersed, but quickly regathered and went back to throwing stones. The protests spread to Gaza, where Israeli forces killed at least 7 Palestinian demonstrators, wounding more than 90, according to the Palestinian Red Crescent. At Friday prayers in Gaza, Hamas leader Ismail Haniyeh praised what he called the heroes of knives and lone attacks, saying that the battle for Jerusalem is our battle. And there were more such attacks. Outside the Israeli settlement of Kiryat Arba in the West Bank, a Palestinian man was shot dead after he tried to stab a police officer and grab his weapon. While in Afula, an Israeli town just north of the West Bank, an Israeli Arab woman was shot multiple times by off-duty security personnel. Police say she had taken out a knife, although it's not clear in the video what she's holding. Reacting to the incident, an Israeli Arab member of the Knesset accused the Israeli police and media of encouraging execution of Arabs in cold blood, all contributing to tensions at a fever pitch.
Heightened security is continuing in and around all of the country in the different areas, including major cities, Jerusalem, Tel Aviv, and in the south.
And against this backdrop, the few appeals for calm are being drowned out by the roar of clashes. Ben Wedeman, CNN, the West Bank.